type of curvilinear motion, which is encountered pretty, which is encountered pretty often in real world situations. And this is projectile motion. So all basically defense related applications. So अगर आपने जाके NESCOM में काम करना है तो NESCOM का सबने सुना है या नहीं? Okay. So a large number of defense related things basically have this sort of projectile motion. This includes rockets, bullets, and so on and so forth. Now, what exactly is projectile motion? It's something pretty straightforward. It's essentially a motion just made. The causing force of the motion just occurs at the launch. Just like if you have a rocket, there's only something, I'm talking about the simplest type of rocket, jo ek dafa launch ho gaya, uske baad there is no controlling mechanism involved. Ballistic missile, exactly. Okay. So the force that causes the motion only exists at the launch, and then beyond that, the only other force that acts on the particular particle is gravity. That's it. So there are other, of course, applications of this motion as well, such as when you are, let's say, kicking a ball like so. Now in this case, there is of course a force at the launch, okay, it disappears after that, and then beyond that, there's just gravity acting on the particle. Now the important thing to note during the motion of the particle is, us pe sirf ek hi force act kar rahi hai, and that is acting in which direction? Y direction, in the negative y direction, which means we only have acceleration in that direction in which we have a resultant force. So that means that for projectile motion, we only have a velocity, we only have an acceleration. We only have an acceleration. We only have an acceleration acting downwards. That's it. No other acceleration in the horizontal direction. And that's the key aspect of projectile motion. Now, knowing that information, we can very easily start to analyze the kinematics of this particular projectile motion, right? So let's jump right into it to consider ke hota kya hai. Okay. Yes. So as we've already discussed, there's zero acceleration in the horizontal direction, and there's only acceleration in the vertical direction acting because arising because of gravity.
Right.
So, oh yes, one more example of this. I'll come back to this in just a second, actually. Remind me, Kay, there's something that I've skipped and I'm coming back. Right. So let's consider projectile motion as we just discussed. So consider that we have a particle at this initial position of x naught and y naught. Right. As we've already seen, it only has an acceleration in the negative direction, negative y direction, which is equals to g. So if I'm, let's say, defining my positive x to the right and positive y upwards, then this acceleration actually in vector coordinates would be what?
Minus
g, j. Right? It's acting downwards. That's it. So, and no acceleration in the horizontal direction. Now let's make our life a little easier and consider each of the I and the J components separately. Okay? So when I say I consider each of I and J components separately, as we've already seen ke wo individual components pe hi differentiation or integration ho rahi hoti hai, right? Jab hum curvilinear motion humne karna shuru kiya tha. So start off first with the I components, which means the horizontal motion. Okay, let's first just look at horizontal motion. So what do I know about horizontal motion of this thing? Is there an acceleration in this direction? Exactly. So the acceleration's x component is zero meter per second square. Zero acceleration, kaun sa case hota hai? Ya usme kya hota hai? Constant velocity, exactly right. Now constant velocity is a case that we've already considered. इसीलिए मैंने अपनी पुरानी वाली ये सारी equations यहाँ लिख दी थी. इनमें से कौन सी constant velocity वाली थी? आप लोगों को clear नजर भी आ रहा है? Sorry, this, can someone turn that and this that light off? That will be from that side. सबसे सामने वाली अली से एक रह गई जो जो मेन हमने ऑफ कर दिया. ट्राई तो करें आप. ऑलवेज गिव इट अ शॉट. राइट, थिंक इट इज समथिंग अ लिटिल डॉजी बट एनीवे. ओके, सो वी हैव आवर स्टैंडर्ड किनेमैटिक इक्वेशन व्हिच वी आर आल्सो फेमिलियर विद. नाउ आउट ऑफ दीज व्हिच वन वाज द कांस्टेंट वेलोसिटी केस? बॉटम लेफ्ट, ये सबसे पहली वाली जो है, दिस वॉज माई कॉन्स्टेंट वेलोसिटी. जिसके अंदर इट्स ओनली द पोजिशन दैट्स चेंजिंग. कॉन्स्टेंट वेलोसिटी से मतलब ये हुआ कि उसकी वेलोसिटी इन द हॉरिजॉन्टल डायरेक्शन विल जस्ट स्टे एज इट इज. राइट, विच मीन्स के जो भी इनिशियल वेलोसिटी उसको दी गई थी वी नॉट एक्स, इवन व्हेन आई रीच समवेयर हियर, इट विल स्टिल हैव द सेम हॉरिजॉन्टल वेलोसिटी. सो दैट थ्रू आउट माई मोशन आई जस्ट हैव that my vx at any point is equals to v not x. clear? kyunki koi acceleration hi nahi hai. so from this I can write down my expression for my position because this is the constant velocity case. now let me assume ki ye to maine ss mein likha hua tha na, let's just, because you're considering the horizontal motion and horizontal component, let me write that down in terms of the x components. matlab ye ki if I want to find my x component at any point at any point of time, then that's just equal to what? Isko dekhe, exactly. X naught, which is its initial position, plus whatever its constant velocity is, which is V naught X, multiplied by the time. Right? So I have my So I have my expression for the position. So pretty straightforward for the horizontal motion, right? Now let's move to our vertical components. And as we've already discussed, we know that there is only the acceleration due to gravity acting downwards, and that's a constant acceleration, right? Gravity to change nahi ho rahi na. For most common cases, so constant acceleration. Hai. Now, again, this is a case that we're already familiar with, right? This is these three equations that we had considered, which were for constant acceleration. Excellent. So, इसी को use करके we can come up with the velocity, vertical velocity, and the vertical position and how they're changing with respect to time. So, for example, we know that we have this expression for the velocity. So if I write that down for my vertical velocity, if it's only the vertical direction which has constant acceleration, then what will I get? I'll get that my Vy, right? V kya hai? Vy ki direction ki baat hoti hai na? Would then be equal to V naught, sorry, V naught y plus act, right? प्लस ए सी टी. तो ए सी है क्या? माइनस जी. एग्जैक्टली राइट, बिकॉज इट्स एक्टिंग इन द नेगेटिव डायरेक्शन. माइनस जी टाइम्स टी, दैट्स इट. तो वेलोसिटी आ गई. फिर पोजिशन की बारी आई, तो कौन सी एक्सप्रेशन यूज कर लूँ? द सेकेंड वन. द थर्ड वन इज फॉर वेलोसिटी अगेन. सो सॉरी, थर्ड फ्रॉम द एक्सट्रीम लेफ्ट. कंप्लीटली राइट. या so spot on, this is pretty straightforward, and you're wondering ki hum kar hi kyun rahe hain, right? so isliye let me skip to the results, because again, as I just said, they're pretty straightforward. if anybody is confused about what's happening, then please give us a shout out. essentially, horizontal motion is a case of constant velocity because there's no acceleration in that direction, and the vertical motion is a case of constant acceleration because that's the only direction in which the gravity is, there's acceleration because of gravity acting. theek hai ji, so pretty straightforward. Now I wanted to go back to the picture that I'd shown you guys, right? so this one, let's consider this. isme one of the balls, this red ball, it's falling, it's the same old rectilinear motion jo hum pehle consider kar chuke. It's falling in a straight line. Somebody just let it go. Whereas the yellow ball is being given a horizontal initial velocity. It's acting like a projectile motion. Ek launch pe kisi ne usko horizontal direction mein bhi kuch velocity de di thi. So what's happening to these two? Let's have a think about this.
You say indicate everything
in the right value of the law. Exactly right. Aapne to do level aur aage complicated baat sahi bilkul boli hai. Which is exactly right ke the red ball and the yellow ball will both fall, reach the ground at the same time. Why? Because unka vertical motion is exactly the same. They both have just the same downward acceleration acting on them. Whereas only this yellow ball also has a horizontal component of its motion. And because of that component, uska overall magnitude, that is, uski jo speed hogi, wo higher, it will be larger.
Right.
Now, if you think about it, not think about it, just look at it. These boxes help us to consider the motion at sort of different increments of time. तो आप देखें ये स्नैपशॉट्स जो है ना सेम उनके इंटरवल टाइम सेम है मतलब हर किसी में फ्रेम रेट जो था वो कांस्टेंट था तो तस्वीर हर वन सेकंड बाद खिंच रही है लेट्स अज्यूम ओके सो इफ यू नोटिस एट ईच पिक्चर दे बोथ हैव द सेम वर्टिकल पोजीशन मैं किस तरह करूँ ये वाली ज़्यादा आसान है राइट यू कैन सी कि ये दोनों इधर सेम जगह पर पहुँची फिर अगले पे देखें उधर भी यही होगा दे ओवर हियर अगेन देर बोर एट द सेम वर्टिकल लेवल मतलब ये उनकी वर्टिकल पोजीशन सेम रहती है इंस्टेड इट्स ओनली द हॉरिजॉन्टल कंपोनेंट व्हिच इज डिफरेंट नाउ कंसिडर इवन हॉरिजॉन्टल वाले में भी देर इज समथिंग इंटरेस्टिंग दैट्स हैपनिंग व्हिच इज कि आप सबको आई एम श्योर अब याद हो गया है कि प्रोजेक्टाइल मोशन में हॉरिजॉन्टल मोशन इज द केस ऑफ कॉन्स्टेंट वेलोसिटी ठीक है क्योंकि एक्सीलरेशन जीरो कॉन्स्टेंट वेलोसिटी का ये मतलब हुआ कि अगर मैं हर एक सेकेंड बाद तस्वीर ले रही हूँ तो सेम डिस्टेंस ट्रैवल किया जाएगा या नहीं कॉन्स्टेंट वेलोसिटी सेम होगा सेम मतलब अगर पर यूनिट टाइम मैं देख रही हूँ तो वो हर दफा अगर वो 5 मीटर पर सेकेंड कर रहा था तो वो 5 मीटर पर सेकेंड ही कर रहा है राइट सो लुक केयरफुली हियर एंड इफ यू टेक कंसिडर के अच्छा लेट्स कंसिडर कि इसके और इसके अंदर हॉरिजॉन्टल डिस्टेंस क्या है तो ये था अगले इंक्रीमेंट पे इफ यू लुक एट इट अगेन ओके दिस लुक्स वेरी सिमिलर जो पिछले से गुजरा है एंड सो ऑन दैट इज द हॉरिजॉन्टल डिस्टेंस ट्रैवल्ड इज द सेम एट ईच ऑफ दीज टाइम इंक्रीमेंट्स बिकॉज हॉरिजॉन्टल वेलोसिटी इज कॉन्स्टेंट ठीक सो जस्ट सम इंटरेस्टिंग थिंग्स टू नोट हियर ओके अच्छा वन मोर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग दैट आई फॉरगॉट टू मेंशन प्रीवियसली इसके द ओनली वे वी आर अज्यूमिंग दैट देयर इज जीरो एक्सेलरेशन इन द हॉरिजॉन्टल डायरेक्शन इज इफ यू आर अज्यूमिंग देयर इज नो फ्रिक्शन और ड्रैग और एयर रेजिस्टेंस एग्जैक्टली राइट वरना अदरवाइज एयर रेजिस्टेंस इट कॉजेज अ डेसेलरेशन इट स्लोज समथिंग डाउन सो इन दिस केस ऑल द प्रोजेक्टाइल मोशन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट Does not have any air resistance. Great. Okay. So any questions? Nahin, sab kuch bahut aasan ho gaya. So let's jump in and do some examples for projectile motion. Everybody with their pens and papers out. I'll do this first one and then I want you guys to do the second one. Okay. So, but I do want ke you help me out for this. What I'm going to do is to sort of come up with a systematic way of solving these problems. Right? And the first thing that I'm going to do in my systematic way is, as always, I'm always going to set up my frame of reference. That is, coordinate system ko set up karne. Sabse pehla ye karne. Then what I'm going to do next is that I'm going to write down all the available data. So sort of just take a note down the whatever the data is note down data and then number 3 is to apply the relevant kinematic equations this is the straightforward step wise procedure that I'm going to follow Okay, perfect. So with that step, with those steps, let's start to look at this problem. We have a sack that slides off a ramp with a horizontal velocity of 12 meters per second. If the height of the ramp is 6 meters from the floor, determine the time needed for the sack to strike the floor and the range R where the sacks begin to pile up. Okay, so how long does it take ke wo sack gire? Number one. And number two, the range ke wo matlab kahan pe on the floor are they starting to pile up? So the distance R right here is also something that we need to find. Right. Okay, so let's start with this problem. So frame of reference. What I'm going to do exactly, origin establish karte hain apna kahan pe karna hai. What do you recommend? Kahan pe kare?
A point pe
kare. Exactly. Because that's the starting point of the launch, right? Where we know the initial velocities. So that's why that is going to work very well for us. So this is going to be my origin. Either say x and y is being defined. X is defined to the right positive, y is being defined upwards positive. And then what information do I have? I know that the initial starting velocity just has a horizontal component. Exactly right. So it just has a horizontal component and its vertical component is given to us that it's just horizontal. So that is why this is zero. What else do we know? We know the starting position. We know that A pe start ho raha hai. Jidhar I know ke mera x naught is what?
Zero.
Exactly right. I placed my origin there. It's also zero. Right. Apart from this, what else do I know? Excellent. Exactly right. So I know ke meri acceleration ka x component is zero. Why? Because this is projectile motion. And then the vertical component I know is minus g. Perfect. So with that information, let's start to use the particular examples that we have. Let's start with the, sorry, aap log kya keh rahe? Final vertical position. Oh, I completely forgot that. There is, we also know, ke end mein jab wo gir raha hai, so it has basically reached the ground. So we know its final position, which means, sorry, here I know that y final, let's call it y final, is minus 6 meters. And x final is actually an unknown for me. Sorry, it's r. Aisa hi hai. Ab let's see ke hum perhaps let's zoom out and think about ke kaun si expression hamare liye useful hogi. As you guys have already pointed out, hamare paas y final pata hai hame. Theek hai, y final pata hai, which means ke hame ye y direction wali, constant acceleration wali hamare liye kaam ki rahegi. Uski final y position hame pata hai. We know this. So let's just substitute that in there. So I have then y final is equals to y naught plus v naught t, v naught y t minus half g t squared. Straightforward substitution. What do I get? Minus 6. This is 0 plus 0 minus half 9.81 t squared. So t comes out to be 12 divided by 9.81, 1.1 seconds. Okay, I'll just keep producing that for 10 minutes. Thank you. Now that I have my time, do I really need to say anything more? If I want to find the range R where it piles up, then I need to move to my horizontal position, which of course is being given by my constant velocity case, isn't it? So I have x is equals to x naught plus v naught x times t. X naught is 0, so it's just 12 times 1.1. 13 ya kuch aise karke aa jayega, I guess. Approximately 13 meters. Very straightforward. Okay, excellent. So are there any questions related to this? No, pretty straightforward, right? So okay, now let's please, you guys now are in full swing and completely capable of doing a little bit more complicated problem. So let's please consider this one. Now again, this is projectile motion. So there's a snowmobile which is going at 15 meters per second at point A right here. और प्लीज नोट के हमें पिक्टोरियली उसकी वेलोसिटी की डायरेक्शन भी पता है. इट्स एट 40 डिग्रीज फ्रॉम द हॉरिजॉन्टल. ओके, सो वी नो द इनिशियल स्टार्टिंग वेलोसिटी. व्हाट डू वी वांट टू फाइंड? वी वांट टू फाइंड द हॉरिजॉन्टल डिस्टेंस दैट इट ट्रैवल्स और एंड द टाइम इट्स इन द एयर बिफोर इट लैंड्स बैक ऑन द सॉर्ट ऑफ क्लिफ साइड या हिल साइड. सो प्लीज स्टार्ट डूइंग दिस. Again, do remember the procedure. Coordinate system, first of all, you set up the coordinate system, write down the data, and then apply the kinematic equations. Would you like a pen and paper? कर लें वरना बोर होएंगे. कुछ तो करने को आना है. In case this is not visible to people, there's a 3 here, a 4 here, and a 5 here. Telling us basically that what's the slope of this hillside. See it all done? Masks on top of your noses, please. Oh, yes. आई सी व्हाट यू मीन. आप कह रहे हैं कि वी जस्ट नो दिस और ये तो हमें बताया ही नहीं है और ना ये बताया. नहीं नहीं ऐसा थोड़ी है. अभी सोचे यही तो सारा. दैट्स द की पार्ट इन दिस. दैट्स द गेम. ट्राई द ब्रूट फोर्स व्हिच इज राइट डाउन द डेटा व्हिच यू हैव. सी व्हाट दैट हाउ फार दैट गेट्स यू. How is everybody at home doing? रजिस्टर्ड. Not right? Okay, anybody who's done and would like to come and do it for us? Sorry? Of course, of course. Okay, anyone at home who has, अगर आप में से कोई फॉर एग्जाम्पल पेंट के ऊपर लिख के हमें करके दिखाना चाहे, यूर मोर देन वेलकम टू शेयर योर स्क्रीन एंड देन शो अस हाउ टू डू इट इफ़ यू हैव एनी वॉलंटियर्स फॉर इट. बट यू वुड नीड अ माउस फॉर इट. सो अगर किसी, सब लोग लैपटॉप से बैठे हैं, उस पर लिखना मुश्किल होगा. लेट मी नो. ओके, try, because I think try writing here. Okay, basically don't click on any of the button ke baghair hi wo.
मैम ये साइड पर
वो रहे ना, मैम
मैं ये रेस कैसे होगा?
सॉरी,
रेस
रेजर. ओके, कंट्रोल ई एंड यू गेट हियर. व्हाट सो स्ट्रेट फॉरवर्ड इज इट?
मैं तो आपको बता दूं, मैंने बोर्ड पे चढ़ के पिक्चर ना भेजा.
आप इसको ऊपर करें, फिर पीछे से बोर्ड. The useful thing was that the people online can see what's happening here. और हमको कुछ नजर भी नहीं आ रहा है. इसमें बहुत सारे इश्यूज हैं. आपका क्या नाम है? सॉरी, इसमें बहुत सारे मसले हैं, हम क्या करें? इस पर चले, आप मुझे बताते जाए. प्लीज, माई विल बी योर स्क्राइब. ओके, क्या करना है? ओरिजिन कहाँ? एट ए. ओके, परफेक्ट. सो आई हैव गॉट माय ओरिजिन राइट हियर एंड आई एम गेसिंग, आई एम जस्ट टेकिंग अ गेस कि आपने टू द राइट एक्स डिफाइन किया होगा और अपवर्ड्स वाई डिफाइन किया होगा, राइट?
मैम, दैट इज आर, हमारे पास एंगल गिवन है.
परफेक्ट,
वी कैन पुट दिस इज आर टैन थीटा.
Excellent. Okay, so because we know the information right here about the cliff side's geometry, then we know ke ye kya hoga. So for example, shall I give these things some words? So for example, I know this r is my final x, right?
Yeah.
And then my final, sorry, my y final would be what?
R tan theta, r into 4 by 3 by
4. R tangent alpha, where this is my alpha?
Yeah.
Okay. Yes, and then tangent alpha I can get from here. It's 3 by 4. So my y final is actually equal to
3 by 4 r.
And
now we can apply the second equation of motion in the vertical direction.
Perfect. So just one second. So this is y final in the negative direction. So this is actually going to be a minus 3 by 4 R, right? It's acting downwards from my origin. Please be careful about that. Right, now let me jump in. I'm slower than you. So I might write down all the information that I have available, which is that I know my X naught and my Y naught are both 0. Sorry, kya naam tha aapka?
Dead.
Dead, sorry, I've jumped in and I've started to write stuff myself. But X naught and Y naught is 0.
Yeah.
And then you've just told me that my X final is R. And my Y final is?
Minus
3 by 4 R.
I can also write the velocity component.
Exactly. I also know that my V naught is at 40 degrees with a magnitude of 15 meters per second. So that means my V naught X is going to be what?
15 cos 40.
Itne kam log kyu bol rahe hain? I thought everybody would know ke it's the horizontal component, right? It's the horizontal component of this thing. Aisa hi hai na? Kya ho gaya? Sab batayein. And then here I have then my V naught Y is equals to 15 sine 40. Please notice ke direction is actually initially upwards hi velocity hai. So this is also a positive, upwards direction mein hai wo. Right? Wo niche nahi ja raha tha directly pehle. It was going upwards. Okay, so from that then I can jump into using my kinematic. Excellent, exactly. As before, I can use this one. You want to use the position one?
The position one
for vertical, Y, right? Yeah. For vertical. So for vertical motion, it's probably better to actually keep writing a vertical motion or horizontal motion. For vertical motion, I have my YF is equals to Y naught plus V naught Y times T minus half GT squared as before. Aisa hi hai. The substituting things right in there, I'll get VF is minus 3 by 4 R is equals to Y naught is 0, V naught Y is 15 sine 40, minus half 9.81 T squared. Excellent, ye ho gaya. Similarly, ab horizontal ko kar le. Exactly. Okay, so horizontal motion aa gaya next. Bored out of your minds you all are. For horizontal motion, I know it's a case of constant velocity. So XF, this one, this expression right here. X naught plus V naught X times T. XF is R is equals to 15 cos 40 times T. Perfect. And now if you notice, we have two equations with two unknowns. So we just solve them using simultaneous equations and so on, and we will get our answer. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you. So again, just the upper se zoom out karke lag raha tha ki kuch information missing hai. Lekin it's actually everything is available to us. Just in this case, pichli dafa mein it was just linear equations jo hum directly solve kar rahe the. Whereas in this case, we need to use all the information available to us to construct our simultaneous equations and then solve them together. Any questions for this problem? Anybody who's stuck? Now, I just want to point out that you will not be provided these special the equations for projectile motion separately. The reason being because if you understand that it's horizontal motion with constant velocity or vertical direction with constant acceleration, then you can just use these expressions right here. Our favorite ones. Okay? So isliye yaad karne ki zarurat nahi hai. Just understand how they're coming about. Perfect. Okay. After this, I think there's another problem in there. But mujhe aap log ek to lag raha hai ki you have all figured it out. But dusra, you all seem so bored that I'm going to skip one of them. Yes? And I hope ki you will all do it at home. नहीं करेंगे तो आई विल ऑफ कोर्स गिव इट इन द असाइनमेंट और समथिंग और बस जस्ट एक और कर लें अब सब एवरीबॉडी इज नाउ क्विक एट इट लेट्स जस्ट डू वन मोर एंड देन वी कैन मूव ऑन फ्रॉम प्रोजेक्टाइल मोशन ओके इन दिस केस वी हैव अ फायरमैन हु इज स्टैंडिंग एट द लैडर डायरेक्टिंग द फ्लो वाटर फ्रॉम हिज होज टू द फायर एट पॉइंट be right here. So we want to determine at what velocity it must come from A, ताके वो B को strike करे, given के उसका hose की direction is 20 degrees. Okay? So let's pop this information down. So this theta is equals to, we know the final position of the water particles. Okay. Again, where should I put my origin? At A, exactly right. So please notice, for projectile motion, we're always placing our coordinate system, the origin, at the launch point. कैसे ये कैसे हो गया? ठीक हो गया? चलो आज घर वाले सब लोग वाकई सोने चले गए हैं. Okay, what are we getting? रेड शर्ट हो गया. Twenty-eight point something. Oh no. देखिए लगता ऐसा है कि हम सबको आता है लेकिन फिर भी कुछ गड़बड़ हो जाती है. मेरे साथ भी ऐसे ही होता है वैसे. Anyone here? Ali Raza, please take a picture of your solution and send it to us. We are all struggling here. हमारे सबके इधर उधर गलत जवाब आ रहे हैं सिवाय one person. अच्छा tell me, do you all tend to solve simultaneous equations in a calculator? या खुद करते हैं? मैं इससे पूछ रही हूँ क्योंकि ये ऐसा एक मैंने पिछले कुछ सालों में रिवाज देखा था. इंक्रीजिंगली लोग कैलकुलेटर के अंदर ही यू नो यू कैन सॉल्व साइमल्टेनियस इक्वेशन तो वो कर रहे होते थे और उसमें कुछ ना कुछ गड़बड़ हो जाती है कभी कभी. क्लोज इनफ यस 28 पॉइंट समथिंग है विच इज 29 मीटर्स पर सेकंड. अली क्या हुआ? व्हाई आर यू कंफ्यूज्ड? What are you confused about? Please ask. Yes, you are right. Aleen, so no confusion, you're completely right. It's the vertical component of the velocity is downwards, which means that to begin with, it will be a minus v. Spot on. What is the spot on? I didn't used to. Yes, good, Aleen. Okay, so let's see what the solution is. Anybody who's still confused, please ask, okay, where are you getting stuck? Black shirt. Koi confusion? Kar rahe abhi bhi aap? Kahan pe aap pahunche? सॉल्व करने पे. ओके ठीक है. आई वंडर इफ पीपल आर स्टिल सॉल्विंग और यू आर ऑल डूडलिंग नाउ. शुड आई टेक दिस लॉग? आपका क्या नाम है? सॉरी, माधली. आहद अली, आहद इतनी देर से करके इंतजार कर रहे हैं आप लोगों का. ओके, आई थिंक मोर देन 50% इज एक्चुअली स्टिल डूइंग, बट मोर देन नियरली 50% इज डन. सो आई एम गोना स्टार्ट लुकिंग एट दिस. So again, remember that I want to start off by placing my origin at the launch site, and then I'm, as before, I'm going to define x to be to the right and y to be positive upwards. Now let me just, I'm not going to write it down, for zyada der lagti, so I'll just run through the solution in this slide. Right, so let's start by writing down all the pieces of information that we have. We know, first of all, ke, yes. So let's just consider the horizontal motion first. ठीक है, sorry, मैंने एक और step jump कर लिया, which is के अलग अलग data पहले लिखने के बजाय सीधा ही equations में डालना शुरू कर दिया. So doing that, I know that for my horizontal motion, I have my final position of 20 meters, my initial position of 0, and the velocity to the right with a component of the total velocity, which is VA cos 20. And please notice के the velocity is indeed to the right and then downwards. ठीक है, तो उसका horizontal component is positive to the right here. That's why I have this expression right here. So इसके अंदर I have two unknowns. I don't know what the magnitude of the velocity is. That is what the speed is. Neither do I know what the time is. So this is my one simultaneous equation that I get. Then let me consider my vertical motion. And as before, I can see that my vertical ki final position known. So it's the position equation that I need to use, right? Which for the case of constant acceleration was this one. Which for the case of constant acceleration was this one. Now substituting in my data for it, I know that my final S is minus 10, right? Downwards S, yeah, I've got a minus 10 meters. My initial position is 0, starting at the origin. And then what do I have? My initial y direction velocity is also downwards. I say, you know, it's acting downwards, which is why I end up with a minus component in there. So minus VA sine 20. And then for the time, I've already substituted in kya time tha from my first equation. And finally, minus half 9.81, the standard time squared. And solving this, I can find k my velocity actually turns out to be 28.57 meters per second. Right. So it's actually, again, I know I keep saying it's straightforward. Like, if you are stuck somewhere, please let me know so that we can clarify anything that might be wrong. ये देखे ना ये माइनस ही तो है. ओके थीटा जो है देखें ये हमारे पास वेलोसिटी की डायरेक्शन है. ठीक है. अब वो जो थीटा है इट्स जस्ट गिवन एज एन एंगल, इट्स नॉट लाइक अ वेक्टर और एनीथिंग. ठीक है. तो ये थीटा इज जस्ट 20 डिग्रीज. अब हमारी अपनी मर्जी है कि इस एंगल की इंफॉर्मेशन को यूज करके इस वेक्टर की प्रोजेक्शन फाइंड करें. सो इस डाउन इस किस्म की डायरेक्शन का वेक्टर का आई कैन सी के टू द राइट इट्स पॉजिटिव और फिर इट्स डाउनवर्ड्स. हेड टू टेल रूल होता है ना, ये हेड टू टेल से मुझे ये टोटल मिलेगा. सॉरी क्लॉकवाइज और एंटी क्लॉकवाइज एंगल्स के मैं आपको यही तो कह रही हूँ कि इधर एंगल इज नॉट बीइंग ट्रीटेड लाइक सम सॉर्ट ऑफ अ वेक्टर विद अ पॉजिटिव साइन कन्वेंशन एंड सो ऑन एंड सो फोर्थ. इट्स जस्ट कि ये ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक आपके पास ट्रायंगल गिवन है. प्लीज आपस में आहिस्ता. हेलो आप दोनों एक सेकेंड जस्ट केवल पॉज हो क्योंकि अक्रॉस बात नहीं जा रही. जस्ट वन सेकेंड प्लीज. सो ओवर हियर इट्स जस्ट एन एंगल. देर इज नो कि वो पॉजिटिव है या नेगेटिव है, एंटी क्लॉकवाइज है या क्लॉकवाइज है, कुछ भी नहीं है. उसकी कोई डायरेक्शन है ही नहीं एक्चुअली. इट्स जस्ट दिस एंगल इन अ ट्रायंगल. ठीक. इसकी वजह से हम उससे ज्यादा उसके बारे में कुछ नहीं हमें चाहिए. ओनली के वी विल यूज दिस टोटल वेक्टर टू प्रोजेक्ट एंड फाइंड इट्स कंपोनेंट्स. ठीक. हाँ जी प्लीज. आप दोनों का कोई कंफ्यूजन नहीं? ओके राइट. सो नो कंफ्यूजन फॉर प्रोजेक्टाइल मोशन. Perfect. Okay, I know we are running out of time, but I just quickly want to move on. I thought I'd have more time, but I want to quickly move on to the next topic, which we will be considering in much more detail next time. Ali Raza, very good. आपने इतना late वो पूछ के फिर भी तेजी तेजी से कर ही लिया. या फिर शायद सिर्फ answer लिख दिया. I'm not sure yet, but I'll take a look at it later. Okay, so the next topic that we are going to move on to, from a little bit of introduction today and then tomorrow in much more detail, is now looking at curvilinear motion but in a new coordinate system, which is actually the NT coordinate system, which stands for normal and tangential components. This N right here, this N is for normal. And T is for tangential. And we'll see shortly what, why these two, the normal tangential and what that means, right? Now this type of, I want to jump into one more thing right here. So please note that when I started off curvilinear motion, I did say that we're going to be considering three different coordinate systems. So abhi se, because I'm starting my second one, I want to bring up this table that I'll come back to later on as well, which is a comparison of these three coordinate systems and how they're similar and how they're different, basically. And essentially what I want to focus on today is that for xy ko to aap logon ne dekh liya, it's a Cartesian coordinate system. For the xy coordinate system, if you remember, we had a fixed origin. Now this NT coordinate system that we're going to be starting off today has this interesting property ke uska origin is not fixed. The origin moves with the particle. And then next time when we'll consider another coordinate system, uski ek aur pieces of information hai which we will discuss later on. But this makes our life a little interesting because of this moving origin. So we'll come to that. Now, when would you be using these different coordinate systems? So we've already seen ke xy Cartesian coordinate systems ke liye we considered the application of projectile motion. Now this NT coordinate system is actually very commonly used for applications jahan pe hume path already known ho kisi cheez. So for example, for airplanes, they have a pretty fixed path that they follow to get from point A to point B. ठीक है, उनको पता है उन्होंने सीरिया के ऊपर से नहीं गुजरना, राइट? सो दैट्स व्हाई देयर इज अ फिक्स्ड पाथ दैट ऑल कमर्शियल एयरलाइंस विल बी टेकिंग, राइट? सो फॉर दिस सॉर्ट ऑफ एप्लीकेशंस वेयर द पाथ इज नोन, वी टेंड टू यूज, एंड इट्स अ कर्विलिनियर पाथ, दैट्स ऑल्सो इम्पोर्टेंट, राइट? वी टेंड टू यूज एनटी कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम्स. नाउ व्हाट हैपेंस इन द एनटी कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम, एज आई सेड, द ओरिजिन इज लोकेटेड on the particle and it moves as we go about. So for example, the particle is right here, then the origin would be here. As I move further, the origin will then be wherever the particle is at that point. Now let's come to its basis vectors. You remember ke Cartesian coordinates mein we had our I, J, K basis vectors. Now for the case of our normal and tangential components, we actually have, we'll be considering in plane problems. मतलब के टू प्लेन, सिर्फ एक ही प्लेन के अंदर होंगे, नॉट इन 3D. देन इन प्लेन वी हैव टू बेसिस वेक्टर्स, व्हिच इज द यूटी, द टेंजेंशियल बेसिस वेक्टर, एंड द यूएन, व्हिच इज द नॉर्मल बेसिस वेक्टर. एंड नाउ दे आर कॉल्ड एज सच बिकॉज द यूटी, दैट इज द टेंजेंशियल कंपोनेंट, इट्स ऑलवेज टेंजेंशियल टू द पाथ. Hence the name, कि जो भी पाथ है उसका जो टेंजेंट होगा उस डायरेक्शन में हमारा ये वन ऑफ आर बेसिस वेक्टर्स विल बी. एंड देन द नॉर्मल बेसिस वेक्टर यू एन, दैट इज ऑफ कोर्स गोइंग टू बी परपेंडिकुलर टू यू टी, बट परपेंडिकुलर विद अ पॉजिटिव डायरेक्शन विच इज टूवर्ड्स द सेंटर ऑफ द कर्वेचर ऑफ द पाथ. ओके, आप इसको नोटिस करें ना कि ये यू कर्व कर रही है ना, सो इट्स सेंटर ऑफ कर्वेचर इज गोइंग टू बी लाइंग समवेयर इनसाइड इन हियर, दैट इज कॉनकेव साइड पे, दिस इज द कॉनकेव साइड इन हियर, उस साइड पे यू एन इज कंसिडर्ड पॉजिटिव. सो ओके, सो परफेक्ट, वी गॉट आवर यूनिट वेक्टर्स, एंड एज आई हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड दैट पॉजिटिव एन एक्ट्स टुवर्ड्स द सेंटर ऑफ कर्वेचर, positive t acts in the direction of the I'll come to that, in the positive velocity. I know I'm running out of time, so we will pick up here tomorrow with the normal and tangential components in much more detail. Right, thank you very much. Thank you.
Deadline agent se delay ho sakti hai.
क्या हुआ सर?